prepared by Muhammad Azharuddin RB, Class 7th, KV Bagalkot. English. The ashes that made trees bloom. Theme. It is a Japanese story that gives importance to values such as honesty, compassion, diligence, with a dash of magical realism. The spirit of the pet dog is the old couple's make-believe determination to get over personal setbacks and begin life anew. Once upon a time, there was a very kind old man and his wife living in a certain village. Next door to them lived a very mean old man and his wife. The kind old couple had a little white dog named Muko. They loved him very much and always gave him good things to eat. But the neighbor was a mean old man who hated dogs. And every time he saw Muku, he threw stones at him. One day, he began barking very loudly out in the farmyard. The kind old man went out to see what was the matter. He kept barking and began digging in the ground. "Oh, you want me to help you dig?" asked the old man. So he brought a spade and began digging. Suddenly his spade hit something hard. He kept digging and found a large pot full of many pieces of gold money. Then he thanked him very much for leading him to so much gold and took the money to his house. Now the mean old man had been peeping and had seen all this. He wanted some gold too. So the next day he asked the kind old man if he could borrow him for a little while. "Why, of course, you may borrow him if he will be of any help to you," said the kind old man. The mean old man took him to his house and out into his field. "Now find me some gold too," he ordered the dog, "or I will beat you." So Muko began digging at a certain spot. Then the mean old man tied him up and began digging himself. But all he found in the hole was some terrible smelling garbage, no gold at all. This made him so angry that he hit him over his head with his spade and killed him. The kind old man and woman were very, very sad about Muko. They buried him in their field and planted a little pine tree over his grave. And every day they went to his grave and watered the pine tree very carefully. The tree began to grow very fast, and in only a few years it became very big. The kind old man said, "Remember how he used to love to eat rice cakes? Let's cut down that big pine tree and make a mortar. Then with the mortar we will make some rice cakes in memory of Muko." So the old man cut down the tree and made a mortar out of its trunk. Then they filled it up full of steamed rice and began pounding the rice to make rice cakes. But no sooner did the old man began pounding than all the rice turned into gold. Now the kind old man and woman were richer than ever. The mean old man had been peeping through the window and had seen the rice turn to gold. He still wanted some gold for himself very badly. So the next day he came and asked if he could borrow the mortar. Why, of course, you may borrow the mortar, said the kind old man. The mean old man took the mortar home and filled it full of steamed rice. Now watch, he said to his wife, when I begin pounding this rice, it will turn to gold. But when he began pounding, the rice turned to terrible smelling garbage and there was no gold at all. This made him so angry that he got his axe and cut the mortar up into small pieces and burned it up in the stove. When the kind old man went to get his mortar back, it was all burned to ashes. He was very sad because the mortar had reminded him of Mukos. So he asked for some of the ashes and took them home with him. It was the middle of winter and all the trees were bare. He thought he had scattered some of the ashes around in his garden. When he did, all the cherry trees in the garden suddenly began to bloom right in the middle of winter. Every day came to see this wonderful sight, and the prince who lived in a nearby castle, he heard about it. Now, this prince had a cherry tree in his garden that he loved very much. He could hardly wait for spring to come so he could see the beautiful blossoms on this tree, on this cherry tree. But when spring came, he discovered that the tree was dead and he felt very sad. So he sent for the kind old man and asked him to bring the tree back to life. The old man took some of the ashes and climbed the tree. Then he threw the ashes up into the dead branches, and almost more quickly than you can think, the tree was covered with the most beautiful blossoms it had ever had. The prince had come on horseback to watch and he was very pleased. He gave the kind old man a great deal of gold and many presents. And best of all, he knighted the old man and gave him a new name. Sir Old Man Who Makes Trees Blossom. Sir Old Man Who Makes Trees Blossom and his wife were now very rich and they lived very happily. Thank you.